Now, are you concerned about the invasive nature of pharmaceuticals or perhaps GMOs in your garden and in our food supply? Well, you might be racist, right? That's for all of you gardeners out there who might use the term invasive species or soil purity when discussing your garden. You might be a suppressed racist. This is, of course, according to senior lecturer Dr. Ben Pitcher, who accused hosts of a BBC Radio 4 Gardener's Question Time of promoting nationalist and fascist beliefs. Now, he's citing the crisis in white identity in multicultural Britain, basically saying that people who appear on the show, they can't express their bigoted political beliefs because they don't want anyone to call them a racist. So they have to express themselves and their racial identity in ways such as talking about gardening. Now, he said the distinction that gets made between native species and non-native species and this kind of policing of what belongs and what doesn't belong, I think it's symptomatic of a kind of desire to defend the fantasy of the national space. Of course, right? Because any gardener who is concerned about weeding out invasive species is a closet racist. I can't even believe this whole war on whites, this racist meme has now spread to gardening, of course. And if you had any doubts about this new agri-terror, the feds, they've shut down a seed library in Pennsylvania because this is the new terrorism, self-sufficiency. Basically, they shut down this library system, telling them they were in violation of the 2004 Seed Act, which regulates the selling of seeds. Now, this was under the justification of preventing the growth of invasive plant species, cross-pollination, and poisonous plants. So the feds are basically racist right now, shutting down this seed place because they didn't want any invasive plant species. Now, the library was, of course, attempting to encourage residents to learn more about growing their own food and acquiring key self-sufficiency skills by letting locals borrow seeds and then return them at the end of the growing season. But, you know, here in America, self-sufficiency is terrorism to the state, so they shut it down. Now, the Cumberland County Commissioner Barbara Cross, she applauded the USDA's decision, warning that allowing residents to borrow seeds could have led to acts of agri-terrorism. Right. Now, one woman commented, "Gosh, this makes me wonder when they are going to crack down on all of those GMO fields with their grave concerns about cross-pollination. Look out, Monsanto." Oh, wait. This only applies to regular people growing regular vegetables. GMOs aren't considered an invasive species. And that is the America that we live in now. 2 + 2 = 4. You can't have your own seeds. You can't be part of a seed library. Monsanto can cross-pollinate all they want to. They're not in violation of the 2004 Seed Act. And of course, they are now protected under the so-called Monsanto Protection Act, and there's nothing that you or I can really do about it. Well, thank you for tuning in to the show tonight. And if you like what you see here, please hop on over to prisonplanet.tv and become a member. You can get instant access to the Alex Jones Show, all of our special reports, the movies, the rants, and our ebooks, as well as all of our content right there. And you can share your username and password with up to 11 people at the same time. That is 11 people getting all of the information they need to fight the info war. Now, coming up right after this, we are going to be airing the full 40-minute interview with retired Marine Colonel Pete Martino. He has something to say about the Homeland Security See Something, Say Something campaign. He says that whole campaign prompted him to say something about what he sees as this extreme buildup of arms against the American people. City of Austin tap water versus filtered City of Austin tap water.
I can like taste dirt in it.
God knows what's in this.
This has an aftertaste. Tastes like Austin water?
Yeah, it does. Ugh.
These people just sampled City of Austin tap water straight from the faucet. Next, we had them try a sample of tap water filtered with a ProPure G2.0 filtration system.
High quality H2O.
That one is better.
Tastes like nothing.
Yep, I know what good water tastes like. It's good water.
Most tap water contains added substances like fluoride, chlorine, Monsanto's deadly pesticide, glyphosate, and many others. Studies prove that these substances are linked to an assortment of major health issues, including tooth decay, lowered IQ, and even cancer.
It tastes like you're drinking out of the lake when you're drinking tap water.
Yeah, it has that processed flavor to it.
The ProPure G2.0 filtration system removes these deadly substances and many more, leaving only fresh-tasting, deliciously clean water.
Okay, this is very tasty.
It's good water.
Refreshing.
It's good.
Go to InfoWarsStore.com today. Use promo code WATER and save 10% off your ProPure purchase. Again, that's InfoWarsStore.com or call 1-888-253-3139.